Great jobs, right?
在一整排主张美国优先的钢铁人护卫之下，美国总统川普无视党内同志和国际盟友的警告，在美东时间3月8日下午股市接近收盘时，以捍卫美国产业和国家安全为由，正式批准对进口钢铝课征高额关税。
Today I'm defending America's national security by placing tariffs on foreign imports of steel and aluminum. We will have a 25% tariff on foreign steel and a 10% tariff on foreign aluminum when the product comes across our borders.
川普在记者会中抱怨，美国受其他国家侵略性贸易的掠夺，遭遇到的倾销情况比过去任何时间、全世界任何国家都还要严重。这是扼杀美国钢铁工厂倒闭、工人失业的罪魁祸首。他接着又为自己动用封存已久的1962年国家安全贸易法找理由，声称钢铁是支撑国家安全的药材，外国倾销钢铝产品就如同对美发动攻击。许多在贸易和军事上对美国最坏的，恰巧就是那些自称美国盟友的国家。最后他总结，要想美国不反击，最实际的办法就是到美国设厂。
We want a lot of steel coming into our country, but we want it to be fair, and we want our workers to be protected, and we want, frankly, our companies to be protected. By contrast, we will not place any new tax on product.Made in the USA. So there's no tax if a product is made in the USA. You don't want to pay tax? Bring your plant to the USA. There's no tax.
这项具有高度争议和敌意的行政命令，在川普签署文件的15天后生效。自此，他将成为白宫近代史上第一个公开为自己贴上正牌保护主义者标签的总统。不过，事实上，这并非美国首次祭出关税壁垒。美国有线电视新闻网 CNN 统计，在此之前多有尝试，只不过都以失败收场。
Back in 1930, Congress passed tariffs on a range of imported goods. It was meant to protect American jobs during the Great Depression. But several nations retaliated. That's what happens usually. And it sparked a trade war. It made things worse, I should say, with U.S. imports falling 40% in 2 years. More recently, in 2002, President George W. Bush imposed sweeping tariffs on steel. A year later, the U.S. had to drop them after the World Trade Organization ruled that they were, in fact, illegal.In 2009, President Barack Obama put tariffs on Chinese tires. According, to a Washington research group, the tariffs did protect 1,200 U.S. tire jobs. But here's the thing, about 3,700 retail jobs were lost as a result.
数据显示，美国2017年进口总额为2.4兆美元，其中钢铝制品只占2%，总量相当于 GDP 的0.2%，几乎微不足道。经济学家估计，一旦调高进口钢铝关税，将全面推升所有相关产业的制造成本，其中雇佣700万人的汽车产业将首当其冲爆发失业潮。另一方面，根据美国商务部统计，目前中国大陆生产全球近50%的钢，总量相当于其他国家的总和。但是数据显示，对美直接出口最多钢材制品的并非中国大陆，反而是加拿大和墨西哥。此外还有南韩、欧盟、日本，其中也包括台湾。这项措施来势汹汹，影响层面广泛，自上周末宣布后就引发各国猛烈的抨击。在巨大的压力下，川普松口，让北美自由贸易协议 NAFTA 的另外两名成员暂时享有豁免。
At the same time, due to the unique nature of our relationship with Canada and Mexico, we're negotiating right now NAFTA. And we're going to hold off the tariff on those two countries to see whether or not we're able to make the deal on NAFTA. National security, very important aspect of that deal.
川普将钢铝关税和 NAFTA 谈判挂钩，另辟战线，让加墨两国得以稍稍松一口气。白宫方面稍后补充，这项命令并非毫无弹性，其他安全和贸易伙伴也可透过谈判争取豁免。 尽管行政命令打了折扣，被外界认为川普政策雷声大雨点小，但是川普求扣榜上有名的欧盟并不手软，表示仍将启动报复措施，对美国进口的柳橙汁、波本酒、花生酱等农产品，以及牛仔服饰织品和哈雷机车等消费和工业产品课征重税。中国大陆以破坏国际贸易规范为由，对关税措施表达强烈的反对。日本、韩国、澳洲则相继对伤害双边关系的措施表达遗憾，强调将积极寻求豁免协商。不过，专家却对后续的发展表示悲观。
Steel tariffs are on, aluminum tariffs are on. There will be exceptions or exemptions for Canada and for Mexico, but for a temporary period of time. So until NAFTA is negotiated, and NAFTA is not negotiated, then things are kind of left hanging. And there was also this talk about countries perhaps being able to.Not face these tariffs if they negotiate with the U.S. administration. But, quite frankly, in the middle of NAFTA negotiations and CORUS negotiations, I just don't see how this administration is going to have the ability to negotiate one-on-one with each different country on steel tariffs specifically. So it still sounds like a mess. Well, we're certainly in a very tense situation right now.We are much closer to that scenario than we were 2 weeks ago.
美国三大股市因川普的态度不如预期强硬，收盘呈现小涨局面。川普杀鸡用牛刀，不止国际社会愤怒，即便美国国内的态度也相当分歧。一项为了打击中国大陆而启动的政策，不但没有打击到中国大陆，还拖累了一堆人。记者会后，川普在一堆钢铁人的目送下心满意足的离场。他的葫芦里究竟卖着什么药？各种道理只有川普自己心里最清楚。